When you see the warning saying two-wheel drive only, traction reduced in the Range Rover Evoque, it may mean that the control modules in your car can't communicate properly with the differential control unit. And it's a major repair covering the wiring harness module software or the module itself. It's almost never connected with the mechanical part of the differential, but the control module. But before you agree to pay for very expensive inspections and repairs, you should try two things that may trigger this warning and some other lights on the dash. First of all, it would be nice to make sure that the 12-volt battery in your vehicle is healthy. The best way to do it is to provide the battery with a load test or use your multimeter and measure the voltage in different conditions. For example, when the car is off, the voltage should not be lower than 12.4 volts. When the engine is being cranked, it shouldn't drop lower than 11 volts. And also, once the engine is started, the voltage should gradually go over 14 volts. The thing is that the low battery and drop in voltage may trigger almost all kinds of messages and warnings, since they affect communication between control modules in your car. Charging the battery or replacing it with the new one may eventually fix the problem. Also, if you see the warning two-wheel drive only, traction reduced, and also the ABS light on the dash, you should scan the vehicle with a good high-end scanner and see which exact ABS sensor malfunctions. Replacing the sensor on a Range Rover Evoque is actually a very straightforward job, and also the sensors aren't that expensive. If you fix your ABS issue, the two-wheel drive only traction reduced warning may be eventually gone after you drive for some time. The secret is that the differential module relies on the wheel speed sensor readings to engage and disengage all-wheel drive when needed, so it will throw the warning if it can't see the readings from one of the sensors. If this doesn't help, you may have a corroded connection somewhere in the differential harness, or the differential control module may be broken, which is not a DIY repair and it requires professional equipment and knowledge to be fixed.